Okay, everyone, I'm in the basement right now. It's kind of just a workshop area where we work on things. So it's kind of a messy environment. But you can handle it. Oh, still, as always, I try to film outside because it's prettier, but there were so many random noises out there, nothing was working out. So I'm down here. I'm down here. Oh no! You guys might hear some noise here for a minute. Oh, there we go. We're good. This is a knife I want to talk about because I have been meaning to talk about this knife for a long time, and I don't know why I kept putting it off. It was like this weird thing with this knife where I just couldn't keep up with getting it done, and I don't know why. This is one of the best knives we have. He'll correct me if I'm wrong, but I'm pretty sure this is actually one of my husband's favorite knives. It's my husband's knives. We share them though. We share the knives. I use it frequently because it's super nice, super lightweight. This is one of those that I can hook on these pants that I like to wear all the time, as you've heard me say a billion times over. These are like yoga pants. And they're light enough. And they. Sorry. They have a strong clip. They are nice. These are nice. This is nice. For any pants. I mean, it's good on heavy duty pants, but see, I like that it's good on lightweight pants. That's always a nice thing. It's so sleek. And yes, this is Osborne. Osborne. This is the Benchmade Osborne S30 V. Is that the. Yeah. Anyway, if I'm messing up the name a little bit here, I'll also go get corrected on that later. For some reason, I think that's what it's called. That's the blade though. That's the steel. So I'm trying to remember the name of the knife. I just always remember it's the Benchmade Osborne, but my husband's always saying the full name. Oh, I thought that was the name of it. That's a steel. I will get back to you on that. But it is so sleek. This knife is sleek. Let's talk about the material. It's got aluminum scales. And I don't know if you can tell, but those are so. They're set. Oh, there's a good angle. It feels like satin. It feels. There's this satin feel to this. And it just feels so elegant. It feels soft and in that a good way. That satin smooth, satin finishy. And then the back spacer on this knife. I love the back spacer on this knife. I guess some guys don't like. My husband loves it. But to us, the back spacer is awesome. The color, it's kind of purple. And I guess some dudes are like, purple's not a guy color, and I don't think that at all. In fact, my husband's favorite color, I don't know if it still is, has been purple. When we first met, it was purple. He loved purple, and I think purple's an awesome color, and it's got that green and purple, and it's really pretty. It is. Okay. This. You need to push the button. Oh, it opens so strong. This opens so strong. And sometimes knives open so strong that me personally, I don't like it. Usually the ones that open really strong that I'm like, that's a little much for me. Like my husband still loves it. I'm sorry if my mouth is dry. I just realized I probably should have took a drink, but I'll try not to sound nasty. But this isn't too, this is strong, but it's not the strong that I'm talking about where I get like almost like, ah, I don't want to open. But it's still so strong. It's perfect. It's just, it's glorious. It's a glorious strong opening. So here we go. I'm gonna push. It has such a satisfying strong opening. Here we go. Let's do this again. I'm sure you can tell. I mean, you can obviously the best deal is, you know, when you get to have your hands on one. It's sharp. It has such a perfect blade. I mean, I that's the blade's just perfect for use. It's, you know, see, I always do these motions like I'm using it, like opening a box, opening tape on a box, and it's, you know, a perfect size to, you know, it's not too big, it's not too small, it's just so good. And then the, like I said, the clip on this is exceptionally awesome. I have knives that are some of my, I love my knives and they're great knives. But even some of my knives that I'm like, these are great. I still, there's a few of them where I'm like, keep an eye on this one. Make sure it doesn't come out off of your pants while you're out jogging or out hiking or doing something. Because it's not that it's a bad clip. It's really still a good clip. But it doesn't have as much security as a clip like this. This, you see that? That is really pinched down. And I love it. Yet it's not too hard to get on your clothes, and it's not too hard to take off, but it just has, just like I said, enough resistance to make you feel pretty dang secure. Now, we were talking about the satiny, kind of the smooth, oh, so pretty. I love it. I personally love it. My husband also loves it. Like I said, it's his knife, but there is one thing he kind of almost wishes that it had some grippiness to it, just so that it, you know, like texture, just for, like I just said, grippiness. But with that said, he's like, but on the same note, it's like hardly a complaint. I love this knife, it's great as is. You know, it's still just, you know, if he would add it if he could, but still, it's like he's not really complaining. Just, you know, his preference if he could. But look at that blade. Look at the size. You can see the size in my hand. Oop. And then, sorry, I'm careful not to cut myself there. But like, as far as the way this fits in your hand, it's perfection. You can ride your thumb up on it like that. Get that control. It is perfect in. This fits perfectly in my hand. I don't know. I'm just gonna show them off. This is the bench, this Osborne, this Benchmade Osborne, and it is, yeah, it's the, it the safety. So you push the button. I'm talking about the, you know, opening and closing right now, and then you push the button to close, and you push the button to open. You got that button opening. And it's very nice. It's a very smooth button push. It doesn't have, it's not difficult. It's not too easy, so it's not like you're gonna accidentally do it. And but it's not like an annoying and hard, too hard. It's very smooth. Very, let's just, and okay, so there's a safety, right? That will hold it closed for you. So when you, so it doesn't pop open. I mean, technically you could accidentally push this button. Like I said, it's, I don't think it was very too e super easy, but I still would not leave it unlocked. So they have the safety to hold it closed when you're carrying it and don't want it to spring open. But so here you go, see, will not open. It will not open. But nice thing, unlock it. Push it right open. Oh, it's so strong, guys. So strong. And then you can use it this safety can be used to, you push it when this is open, you can push it up and it will keep the blade open. So look, now it won't close on you. So you can either use that safety to hold it closed securely or open securely, and then you want to close it, you just pull it back down, push the button. There you have it. See? And this is just one of the best knives we have. It's glorious. It's perfect in size. It's handsome. It's sleek. It, like I said, it's got that kind of it's got that class to it. I've talked about that with some other knives. There's some knives that have a classy look. This is one. Perfect EDC size, everyday carry size. Push button auto. And I, you know what? I really just, this is talking about the looks again, but doesn't that look pretty? This, the way that that's carved, that handle's carved out. I think it's absolutely gorgeous. You got S35VN steel, which is phenomenally, wonderfully great steel. And I'm just trying to think for a minute if there's anything else that I really wanted to talk about. Like I said, I wonder how many times I've said this in my videos that I'm super ADHD, but you're probably going to keep hearing it because that's my life. But yeah, the color, everything, and this, it's so good. It's such a good knife. Now, I showed you briefly. Now, see, I have a seam right there on my pants, so I shouldn't have been trying. See, actually, there's a little bit. Okay, see, now, let's see if you can actually just hear that. So, did you hear that? So, I don't know if you can hear that, but the fact that the reason I want you to hear that is because I don't know if it's translating, I need to explain it, but I'm gonna anyway, is you can tell that it takes a little bit to put on the pants, and the fact that you can hear it means it's slipping on nice and snug. You can hear the fabric kind of shh, because it's slipping on nice and snug, and don't be deceived, it's not too snug. Like I said, it's perfect. And then see that? Hear that last little pull? You can tell that clip does not come off easily. See, there is a little bit of like, okay, I gotta get this on the pants. Because that little... Guys, the reason I'm struggling so much is because I'm bent over like this. Okay, it's not like, if I'm just standing here, I'm like, it's gonna be easier doing it on my own. But I'm trying to focus on the camera. I'm really just struggling today. It's not usually this hard. This isn't boding well for what I'm trying to say about the knife. This thing's awesome. But do you hear? You can tell. Based on the sound that this is really gripping on to your clothes and gripping off really well. And it's very nice. It's very, very nice. This is a good knife, and I don't think you can go wrong with it. It's beautiful, it's usable, it's high quality, it's just good. It's a good knife, it's a favorite, and I would recommend. Okay, I realized part of my problem trying to show you that clippy thing. I'm trying to do it awkwardly from the side there, but I'm going to show you from the front. It doesn't matter too much, but I'll just show you. It is easier to pop on than I just was struggling. So, see? Yeah. And it's like performance anxiety there, yeah. Still, there's a little bit of effort, just a tiny, just enough for you to know that it fits really well on your pants. Or, you know, stay secure, but like I said, when I got my bearings about me, and now I'm struggling again. Oh my gosh! No, see, it's not bad. I was just in this awkward position from the side, and I'm trying to
you know, like, do all that stuff, but you can tell that these are just great. These. Why do I keep saying these? It's a knife. It's not multiple knives. But yeah, it's awesome.
I got it straight. I knew I was like, I am not saying the name of this knife. I mean, I'm saying the blade still on it. I'm never completely, but that's another Benchmade right there. But I was like, okay. I mean, I was saying the blade still, which is, you know, oh my heavens. Anyway, we already went over this. S30V blade still, and I kept saying that because I was like, wait, because I knew the name of the name of knife is the Osborne, and it's a number, and my brain just wasn't doing it. But yeah, it's the 940, or like, as you can see now, if it'll focus, we can actually show you for Pete's sake. See, it said it on there, 9400, but you know, it's called the 940 a lot. Benchmade Osborne 940. There's your name. And this is the auto version, obviously. They're not always, this is a different version than the regular one. This is a push button auto. So it's pretty cool. Which you could, you know, you could already tell, but I did not mention it earlier. So there you go.